Amazing Iron Atom, Part 3, by Dr. Anwar Hamdi. All the animations and illustrations were accomplished to the actual scale after meticulous computations to the trustworthy data. The nucleus of an iron atom, which is composed of 26 protons and 30 neutrons, is compacted in an unimaginable volume, and the following is an illustration. You need more than 32 African elephants to balance an empty 747 Boeing airplane. Is it thinkable by any means to imagine that 56 of these Boeing airplanes had been squeezed to be fitted in a volume equivalent to that of a very small drop of water? That is precisely the compressed condition in the iron atom nucleus. The iron atom nucleus will be formed through the proton-proton chain. If two protons collide at high enough speeds, one proton can momentarily plow deep into the other, eventually coming within the exceedingly short range of the strong nuclear force, which binds nuclei together, at distances of less than about 10 to the power of minus 15 meter. The attraction of the nuclear force overwhelms the electromagnetic repulsion and fusion occurs. Speeds in excess of a few hundred kilometers per second, corresponding to a gas temperature of 10 million Kelvin or more, are needed to slam protons together fast enough to initiate fusion. Such conditions are found in the core of the Sun and at the centers of all stars. Around the time silicon 28 appears in the core of a star, a competitive struggle begins between the continued capture of helium to produce even heavier nuclei and the tendency of more complex nuclei to break down into simpler ones. The cause of this breakdown is heat. By now the star's core temperature has reached the unimaginably large value of 3 billion Kelvin, and the gamma rays associated with that temperature have enough energy to break a nucleus apart. This is the same process of photodisintegration that will ultimately accelerate the star's iron core in its final collapse toward a type 2 supernova. Under the intense heat, some silicon 28 nuclei break apart into 7 helium 4 nuclei. Other nearby nuclei that have not yet photodisintegrated may capture some or all of these helium 4 nuclei, leading to the formation of still heavier elements. The process of photodisintegration provides raw material that allows their helium capture process to proceed to greater masses. In succession, the star forms sulfur 32 to the iron 52 and nickel 56. Nickel 56 is unstable. It decays rapidly first into cobalt 56, then into a stable iron 56 nucleus. Any unstable nucleus will continue to decay until stability is achieved, and iron 56 is the most stable of all nuclei. When light nuclei fuse, the mass per particle decreases and energy is released. Similarly, when heavy nuclei split apart, the total mass again decreases and energy is again released. The nucleus with the smallest mass per nuclear particle is iron. It can neither be fused nor split to release energy. Iron's 26 protons and 30 neutrons are bound together more strongly than the particles in any other nucleus. Iron is said to have the greatest nuclear binding energy of any element. More energy per particle is required to break up an iron 56 nucleus than the nucleus of any other element. This enhanced stability of iron explains why some of the heavier nuclei in the iron group are more abundant than many lighter nuclei. Nuclei tend to accumulate near iron as stars evolve. Once the inner core begins to change into iron, the gravity overwhelms the pressure of the hot gas, and the star implodes, falling in on itself. The core temperature rises to nearly 10 billion Kelvin. Like a fast-moving ball hitting a brick wall, the core becomes compressed, stops, then rebounds with a vengeance. At that point, the core rebounds. An enormously energetic shockwave sweeps through the star at high speed, blasting all the overlying layers, including all the heavy elements just formed outside the iron inner core, into space. For a period of a few days, the exploding star may rival in brightness the entire galaxy in which it resides. This spectacular death rattle of a high-mass star is known as a core collapse supernova. Our Sun, in every second, will produce energy equal to about 7 trillion Hiroshima atomic bombs. However, during a supernova, the star releases in a few seconds very large amounts of energy, equal to all the energy that will be released by our Sun throughout its entire lifetime. And the iron is expelled out into space. The minimum temperature required for the fusion of hydrogen is 5 million degrees. Fusing carbon requires a temperature of about 1 billion degrees. And iron formation requires about 3 to 4 billion degrees. To be able to imagine the temperature produced in a supernova one, I made the following analogy. If we present to 100 degrees Celsius, between freezing and boiling of water, as 10 centimeters long. Then the boiling of mercury will be presented as 35 centimeters long. The boiling of lead is 174 centimeters long. The boiling of silver is 221 centimeters long. And the boiling of copper is 256 centimeters long. The boiling of iron is 275 centimeters long. The boiling of gold is 285 centimeters long. The boiling of tungsten is 555 centimeters long. The boiling of rhenium is 559 centimeters long. The temperature in the core of Sun is 15 kilometers long. And the temperature in the supernova is 3,000 kilometers long. The distance between San Francisco and New Orleans. Who is able to generate all these unimaginable powers? Who is able to control these supernovae? Think deeply. And, to be continued.